Welcome to Excel Crafters, the Microsoft Excel tutorial channel. So let's quickly jump into a demo showing what we are trying to achieve today. You have a table here with the name of the student, subject, the internal marks, the external marks, and the final percentage. The final percentage is a formula to get the average of the marks. The goal is set to 60%. Now, if you click on Seek, Excel will automatically populate the external marks that is required for each student to get an average percentage of 60. So this is what we are going to achieve today through this video. The first thing that you have to do is open this Excel that I am referring to. I have provided the link in the video description. Please go ahead and open that. And when you open it, you might get a security warning indicating that the macros have been disabled. Please go ahead and click on Enable Content. You may have already noticed these two buttons here. If you have no clue on how to create those, don't worry. I have a video that explains exactly how to create a button and link it to an action. I will provide that link in the description. Please feel free to explore that video. Next thing, what we need to do is let's go and see the code behind this macro. Now for that, you need to go into your developer tab. And here again, if you don't find your developer tab here, don't panic. I have a video explaining how you can enable developer tab in your Excel. Again, I will link it to the description. Please feel free to go ahead and watch that video. So once you have the developer tab, go into the macros button. Then you can see there are two macros here. You can go ahead and select one of them and then click the edit button. So these are the two macros that we have already defined in this Excel. So we'll go through both of them one by one. I would prefer to finish off this reset button logic initially. So what this function does is it selects the range E5 to E13. So let's see what is E5 to E13. So this is E5 and this is E13, right? It selects this range and then it basically clear the contents in that range. So once you see, this range is filled with values. And the objective of reset is to just select those values and just clear it. Pretty simple, right? So that's all for this part of the code. So now let's look at the GoalSeek part of the code. So first thing that we do here is we define a variable j as an integer, and this is a format to do it. And also note that any statement that starts with a single code is a comment and will not be executed when we run the macro. The comments that I have given here is just for your understanding on what each of the statement does. We saw that yes, j is the variable that we have defined, and we have started a loop here, which is a for loop that goes from the value of j from 5 to 13. Now, where did we get 5 and 13? We want to iterate from this fifth row to 13th row. So this is where we got the 5 and 13. And this is the formula to implement GoalSeek. I've given the explanations here, those cells jf.goalseek. So what this means is these are the cells that needs to be changed to our goal value. So in this case, it is column F. The next parameter is goal. This is telling Excel that this is the goal that needs to be achieved. So in our case, the goal is maintained in the cell H6. So here we are telling that the goal is maintained at cells H6 and changing cell. So you have already seen this goal is achieved by changing the cells in external marks, right? So the changing cell should be all the cells from E5 to E13, right? So in this case, we are telling it is column E. And the next statement here is next J. So what happens is first this iteration will start with J as 5. Once it reaches here, it will change the value of j to 6, and then it runs for the value of j as 6. Okay, and this continues till 13. So that is what this code does. So that was all for this video. Let me know if you have any queries and I'll be happy to answer them. If you like the video, please consider liking it and please consider subscribing. Also, click the bell button while you subscribe so that you will get notified whenever I upload a new video. So until next time, bye-bye.